different cultures, they're different age. You know, everybody has a different skin complexion, but that doesn't necessarily mean they come from the same culture or ethnicity. So I do appreciate that about Boston. You know, you can learn and teach at the same time. Some of the challenges that millennials face in the workplace are feeling that they are doing their due diligence. I feel like a lot of times millennials, especially millennials of color, never feel like they're good enough, or you know, they never feel like they are being seen with their work ethic. Right? So they have to do more. When they're doing more, they still feel overlooked. So they never feel like they're doing enough, which can also lead to you overworking yourself, and then you're just not happy. So now you're resenting not only your job or the people around you, sometimes it ends up with you resenting yourself and putting so much effort, and then you just crash, and now you either don't want to work or you don't feel appreciated.
How could that, do you think events like this, the fierce you see it now, can help correct that?
I believe it can help. It can help, not necessarily correct, but can help other millennials see that they're not alone in this battle. It can help with networking and meeting other people who are going through the war, you know, how you're feeling, or maybe have advice on how to accept it, or how to change it, or how to somehow adjust to feeling that way.
Shall I?
The Fun Festival makes millennials feel like they're not alone.
Good.
Okay.
Thank you, Michelle.
You're very welcome.
That was a great job.
Soul record from the 70s. Essentially, what we're doing is we're chopping this right now. And then we're going to do it through the vinyl. Right through the interface. And then right when we came through the interface, we're going through the program. We're listening to it. And that's what you said earlier, Serato. We brought it.
I did.
Yeah.